If you like the video, please like, share, and subscribe. Hello everyone, Melkadrian here, and I'm here to play Momodora Reverie Under the Moonlight. It's finally taken some time, but I've actually managed to get this game. It's actually been in my inventory for a while now, but I haven't exactly played it because A, I was still working on Super Win the Game, and B, I was recovering from a bit of a cold. Still recovering from it. Things are always so long-lasting. Anyways, Momodora is... how do I put this? It's pretty much like the other Momodora games, except it's more brutal in combat. Think of brutal combat in the soul's thoughts, where damage is really, really painful. Let's go with keyboard. For people who are used to playing side-scrolling games. For people who want a tougher challenge. For people who aren't used to playing video games. I'll go with normal. I've actually played the other Momodora games, since this may not be as hard as it is. A lot of detail in this game. I'm afraid this is as far as I can take you. I'm sorry. Anything close to the city is too dangerous. Surely, that shouldn't be a problem for a priestess like you. Fighting using a leaf must be difficult. Even if it's a maple leaf. But I have faith in your ability to seal the curse away. It has spread to your land too, after all. For now, maybe the best you can do is seek an audience with our queen. Left, right, down, up, movement. And there's a little boat. Unfortunately, jumping in that is pretty lethal. Oh, the guy just left. It's interesting that this character has a black dress on her. Who is this person anyways? I mean, we don't know her name right now. I mean, we don't exactly know characters' names until at the credits. You know, like in Momodora, Momodora 2 and 3. You know, when we get to see Momodora, that sort of thing. Bellflower. Open menu, use equipped item. Bellflower. Restores a small amount of HP per use. Sour flower with restorative powers. Ooh. That's gonna be useful. Haha. Take that. Take this. Beat him up. So far they're not hard. So far anyways. Then again, it's these sorts of guys where, well, where it's basically easy to beat them up because they have to rev up. Anyways, we have a bow instead of firing talismans, which the other maidens had in Momodora 1, 2, and 3. Well, actually, Momodora 1 had Dora firing guns and... guns and not bows, any, well, various weapons. Hit bells to save progress and restore your items, or you can pray at it to use a warp, so long as you know where the bell is. It's nice that they brought in the hit the bells for saving the progress. I was really missing it from the previous game. Roll behind enemies. Ow! Well, that certainly didn't work. Took a good chunk of my health, too. You know, Are those little imp girls? And even so, maybe they're ninjas. Maybe they're wearing full body suits. because I shudder to think if they're actually... Anyways. Whoa, there's something up there. No block or anything, so I guess we go down. This character has the sort of appearance of, Momo's sister. Kind of beat up now. Let's use those bell flowers. Replenishes health, but not a whole lot. Gotcha. Vitality fragment. HP has been increased. Aww. Somehow I was missing... That's very nice. Although I'm still missing the whole... You know, love letter from Momodora 2. I don't know. Words of love, strengthening you. It's got a nice feeling to it. Hello. Ow. Looks like we can get across it. Astral Charm. What's this do? Passive effect. Sometimes enemies will drop twice as much money. Okay. Doesn't seem to be anything else over here, so let's ignore this thing. Big and scary. No recoil on that one. Oof. Whoa. Stop firing them nades. Ouch. Kinda ran into that one. Okay, there's an orb. Shoot it. Shoot it. There we go. Yeah, you keep throwing grenades at the wall. You seem to be having a whole lot of fun with that. Just love hitting these bells. It's like playing an instrument. What instrument do you play, miss? I play the bell. That's not exactly an instrument. No, but I really hit it hard. What kind of bell are you hitting? One of these bells? Wow. You got some muscle there, girl. Knife throwers. Hello there. I have no business with you. Go away, you stupid girl. You know, it's not nice calling people stupid. Well, there's still something up there I want to explore and find out what it is. Come on. Haha! Oh, I just shot the knives out of the air with my bow. Oh, I guess there really was nothing up here. Except that small crevice. There really is nothing I can do about that. Let's see. I suppose we go this way. Ha! Treasure! Monies. Money's always good for buying stuff with. Ow. Give me your money. Haha. Take that. My arrow can beat your arrow beats knives. Ha. I wonder what else is part of the arrow knife thing. Leaf arrow knife? Maybe. Patch myself up. Not this way. Yes, that way. There's nothing I can do over there. Ow. Aha. We found treasure. We're certainly treasure hunters now. Throw nades at your own leisure. And by your own leisure, I mean whenever you feel like it, I guess. And we're poisoned. And it's gone. No, it's still there. Now it's gone. Okay. Oh, we got a barrier. And a caterpillar anthropod demon idea. Ow! Yeah, this is gonna get some getting used to. Because, I can tell you, fighting with a keyboard like this, not easy. We almost got it. We almost caught it. Yes! Huh. It died standing. Now what's interesting is that... Well... If you defeated that boss at full health... Well... Not at full health. Without taking any damage, you get a special item. Out of it. A boss item. For a reward for not taking a hit. I'm not going to be doing that though. If I take a hit, then I take a hit. I'm not gonna get any special loot out of it if I do. I'm sorry. Who are you? I see. So you're a Kaho, huh? What a unique name. Kaho. I thought that's the title of the priestesses. Or maybe that's her name itself. Call me Asgorn. I take it you're unaware of the situation of these lands? You mentioned your journey brought you here in search of the Queen. If you really intend to continue further into the Kingdom of Karst, beware. A ghastly presence has been enveloping everything. The Sacred Grove is one of the few untouched spots. Okay, anything else you can say? Karst City is ahead. As dangerous as it is now, I must visit it in to search for a beloved one. Well, I hope you find your beloved one. Karst City. It's just surprising going from a nice peaceful grove to a dark looming. Not a dark looming. A dark... What's the word I'm looking for? A dark feeling of... An impressive feeling. An oppressive atmospheric area. I mean, I really want to just sit here and listen to the atmosphere. Take in the atmosphere of this area. And by the looks of it, Karst has really taken the biggest hit in this curse. Even their moon is red. And a small moon, too. Anyways, we'll get to exploring Karst City at a later time. So until then, this is Belkadrian, and this is the playthrough of Momodora, Reverie Under the Moonlight. If you like the video, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and comment down below, if you want to. I do appreciate it if you do, though. Have a great day, and happy gaming!